Well, firstly, I must actually acknowledge that this is a very painful experience that our people are going through. It's a very unacceptable situation that cannot continue unabating. Government is doing everything possible to deal with the situation and really confront this thuggerism that is happening here. Done by thieves who are actually literally grabbing the livestock of our people at gunpoint, killing our people. So it just can't happen under the democracy of the government of the people, for the people, by the people. We brought in subs today and the South African National Defense Force. They've been deployed. We've heard a lot of stories. I think our people have got a lot of suggestions on the correct deployment and placement of the resources that we have. But I think the call is about us reinforcing more resources for our effectiveness and efficiency on the ground. It's not easy to deal with this situation because it's a situation that happens between the two countries. It has got issues of foreign policies. It needs a very carefully management of diplomatic relations. It's an issue that I'm going to be escalating to President. To follow up on certain matters, I will be also talking to the Minister of International Relations, the DECO Minister around certain areas. I will be speaking to Minister of Police as well as Minister of South African National Defence Force. It needs a collective effort, and I think it's a matter that we've been dealing with it over a period of time. And yes, the report from SAP shows that there is a decline in this kind of situation, this stock theft in certain areas. I think we've got only two areas that they highlighted, but I think the effort is there to really deal with this. And the risky situation of Matatiele being the border between that and the border that is also not well manned is a challenge that we needed to look at it. We've got to improve the security arrangement around this area. We have made a lot of commitment, but I'm quite also pleased to see farmers, commercial farmers, also being concerned and keen to assist in all efforts that are out there, donating about 10 horses to South African police services to ensure that soldiers and police are able to climb mountains, the areas that are really not easy to access due to the topography. So from this meeting, it's very clear on what we should be doing. I think we just need to employ a lot of the latest technologies to deal with this and handle it. What is painful is that we've got more than 500 cattle that are in the Lesotho, and some of them are dying in the compounds there where they've been pounded, and some are being auctioned. This is a very, very sad story, and our people here are losing everything. The livestock in our people here is everything. It's their economy, and you can't just allow it to happen like that. And it's not easy to breed a cow. And at a point when you think that a cow must be able to make returns, it gets disappeared, it gets stolen. So it's something that we needed to work with our people and stop. All the inputs that have been made showing some a commitment, and we need a collective effort from both municipalities, district and locally, as well as the province. And I've instructed the HOD of our Department of Safety and Liaising, which we have said it must be community safety. You remember the community safety is an electoral mandate for the 6th administration. So it can no longer be an issue that is not a funded mandate in the provinces. So, I've said, let's go back and look around that and see what can we do to bring in necessary resources. And the Office of the Premier will be central in coordinating that work, as it's a work that needs a solid IGR arrangement.